Hello everyone,
Welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today I have this inspiration video for you. The pages that I liked color in March, and yeah, I picked out a bunch of coloring pages and I was not even done. I'm feeling so inspired to color so many pages at the moment that I just had to stop myself. Otherwise I had maybe triple the amount of books laying on my desk, and yeah, I'm sure I'm not able to color in them all. So those are already plenty of coloring books to start in, and yeah, let's have a look at the pages that I picked out. Let me first move all the books to the chair next to me so we can move them out of the way. And I like to color again in the Seasons coloring book by Hannah Carlson. I colored, yeah, a few in the book already, and I'm happy with the progress so far in my book. So I really want to color something in it. For this book, I didn't pick out a page. I just put it on the pile so that I can choose whatever I want and what I'm feeling that I like to color. And for some reason, I am always stuck in the season and limit myself to only coloring in the season that we are. So last month I break down the habit and I colored this one in the fall section of the coloring book in the middle of the winter. So that was great. So I hope to be able to do it again and dive in a page that I would love to color. This one I will color already for a long time, so maybe it's a great spring page, right? So, might be that one. But I also feel inspired to color this one already for a few months now. So, yeah, I don't know. We will see, right? How I feel when I start coloring in the book. Then I also put on a pile, of course, my Mondawen coloring book. And I must admit, I really don't feel inspired to color in this book. I color a page for a long time already, every month in the book. So I don't know when it's released. 2001. Yeah, I don't know. I don't think I got this book in 2021. It's confusing me. Maybe I got it already that long, and since I have the book, I try to color in it every month. I like to finish the book someday. There are a lot of pages, but I just not inspired at the moment to color in it. There are many of my favorites finished already, so we will see. Maybe I will allow myself to, yeah, not coloring it in March. We will see what will happen. Yeah, I don't know. Or maybe I will dive in this one. Maybe we will see at the end of March if I allow myself to skip it 1 month or that I really keep going with it. It's one of my favorites, but sometimes you are changing, right? After finishing all my work in progress pages, yes, you hear it right, I completed all my work in progress pages, including one in this one. So I am, yeah, in a space of mind that I'm allowing myself to start a new page in this one. It's a huge one, a big double side spread. And I want to color this one for a long time already. I think it's a very beautiful page in the book. And I would love to color this one. All those flowers and the beautiful girl. And I think, yeah, I can create something that I'm happy with. So I really hope that I feel brave enough to finally tackle this one. After all those years, my favorite one in the book. Can I challenge myself? Let's see. ben ochtendgloren. I didn't call in the book for a while, so I think it's time to pick it up again. And I think this beautiful butterfly with flowers is a perfect one for the springtime. Yeah, I think I'm liking this one. But there are more pages that I would love to color. I also like this one. Yeah, I don't know. Like I said before, I feel really inspired to color a lot of pages, so... Yeah, I would also love this double side spread. Don't know. I already picked out some double pages. This one is also a double page, right? Well, in my mind it is, so... Maybe just stick by this one and let's see at the end of the month. Then I also throw in an untouched book, Mythographic, and it's already a year ago that I got it for my birthday for my older son and I still didn't color in it. And I think it's a shame because the book is beautiful and there are so many pages that I want to dive in and color. And yeah, I picked up this one. There was a little gift tag that is from my son, so I keep it in the book. I didn't realize that I use it as a bookmark, but that's okay. This one is really similar to the one that I've colored in February. I was not happy with the background that I create, so I was thinking I can do the page again and try my techniques again on this one and see if I like the outcome a little bit better and have a beautiful one finished in the book. And if it don't work out again the way that I want, that's okay. There are plenty other pages, beautiful pages, perfect for springtime, and I can try again. Really a perfect book. I'm so happy that I allow myself the time to color in this one. I really hope I do. Magical Earth, then another untouched coloring book by Hannah Carlson this time. Can you believe it? I have an untouched coloring book in my collection by Hannah, one of my favorite illustrators. And it is simply because it's a very good coloring book and I don't feel inspired to color the new ones. So I picked out an older one from the Daydreams coloring book. I finished Daydreams, so yeah, I think it will be fun to color this cat page. I'm really inspired to color this one for a very long time already. And yeah, I never allow myself to color this thing again. So yeah, let's break the habit and challenge myself to color something like this. And otherwise, I always can pick out a different page that I can redo. And I really hope to get started in the book. It's a beautiful book. And I think it's a shame it is in my collection untouched. So it needs some attention. And okay. In my coloring pile. For a few months now. And I still didn't color it. Is the lemon page. So it's rollover from last month. I still want to color it. So yeah. A perfect spring page. That's great, right? I hope I can find some time and inspiration to dive in and not get distracted by other pages, because that was what happened last month. I have my distance and I noticed a lot of books and pages that I really wanted to color, and I kind of forgot about my pile with books that I wanted to color that I picked out for the start of the month. And that's okay. Really, it is okay. But I hope to get something done again in this one. Can you believe it? I picked a page in the Atlantis coloring book to color. And I watercolor this one. This is more a simpler page, a mandala kind of page with some flowers. And I think you can create something very fun with it. Or it's one of them. This one. This is more an underwater scene, also with flowers. Maybe the same flowers even. think it's the same type of flower, so yeah, I'm really inspired to color one of those. Don't know how to and what colors I want to use, and if I will go again for a more muted coloring page, color combination, or that I want to go very bright colors. We will see. We will find out at the end of the month, right? With my completed pages video. Then another winter's coloring book that I put on my pile is by Paula Broen, Amazon. And I know she's working on a new one. I think it's a woman, if I remember correct. So, yeah, it will be lovely to have this one no longer untouched at the moment that she will release a new coloring book. So, yeah, I like the style of the coloring book. And I like both of the pages. So I'm not sure yet which one to color. I feel great about both of them. They are, have some of the similar plants growing. So, yeah, not sure yet which one I will tackle. And in fact, I like it a lot more than the first one because there is now strange things or less strange things growing out of the animals. So, yeah, it's time to get started in the book. It's a beautiful one. And then the last one that I picked out for my inspiration is this Secret Invitation Coloring book. And the paper in this book is lovely. Really, it is lovely. And I think this one. It's a very cute mouse. Oh, no. Those are not mouse. Those are squirrels. Sorry. With a flower bouquet. And I think it will be lovely once it's finished. And I already colored the mouse coloring page on this one. And I think I've used watercolors as a base. And then the prismas on top. And those were great. So yeah. This one is also lovely. There are so many cute pages in the books. And the line work is a little gray. So it is more softer when you finished your page. As you can see. I'm really happy with it. I'm liking the book. So yeah. And working on this paper is really lovely. Really nice. So that was the last one that I really hope to color in March. So let's see. Let me know what is your favorite page from the ones that I picked out. And yeah, I will wish you a very lovely month full of coloring, relaxation, and a lot of fun. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you next time.